All right, so in this module, we're going to start talking about acids and bases, and we're going to start out with some definitions for you. So first, you're going to see two different definitions as to what an acid and what a base are, what they are. The first one is the Arrhenius definition. And according to Arrhenius, an acid is something that when you put it into water, it produces the hydrogen ion, H+. For example, if you were to take hydrochloric acid, hydrogen chloride gas, and dissolve it in water, you make it hydrochloric acid, and it dissociates into the hydrogen ion and chloride ion, produces hydrogen ion, it's an acid. If you take sodium hydroxide, which is you'll see as a base, base is something that, according to Arrhenius, that when you put it into water, it produces the hydroxide ion. And so sodium hydroxide is soluble. You put it into water, it dissociates into the sodium ion and hydroxide ion. There it is, being a base. Useful definition, but we're going to use the next one probably more in this course. Oops. The Bronsted-Lowry definition. According to Bronsted-Lowry, an acid is a proton donor, something that donates protons, and a base accepts protons. It's a proton acceptor. For example, in the reaction between gaseous ammonia and gaseous hydrogen chloride to make solid ammonium chloride, what's happening here is the nitrogen atom with its two lone pairs of electrons is accepting a proton from hydrogen chloride. These arrows here are showing what the electrons are doing. These two electrons here are pulling this proton without its electrons. The electrons are in this bond here. They're staying on the chloride ion away from hydrogen chloride. And when that happens, ammonia gets that extra hydrogen as well as a positive charge, and it becomes the ammonium ion, giving chloride, and it's both of these electrons here, making it the chloride ion with a negative charge. So this, the Bronsted-Lowry definition extends to cases where the Arrhenius definition doesn't fit. In the Arrhenius definition, you have to have water around, and you have to have protons and hydroxide ions around. And things can be acids and bases in situations where that is not the case. Next, conjugate acid-base pairs. So there's a lot of equilibria that occur with acids and bases. For example, if you were to put hydrofluoric acid in water, an equilibrium occurs. And what happens is the hydrofluoric acid molecule donates a proton to the water molecule. When it does, it produces something called the hydronium ion, H3O+, and leaving behind the fluoride ion. Now, this is an equilibrium, so that means it goes the other way. So first of all, okay, notice the words I used. This donated a proton, making it an acid. That's how you know it's an acid. Otherwise, you know because its name. But now we know more. But here, water, it's accepting that proton from hydrofluoric acid, making it a base. But if we look at the equilibrium going the other way, what's going to happen here is the hydronium ion will donate a proton to the fluoride ion, which will accept that proton, making hydronium ion an acid going this way and fluoride a base going this way. Well, there's a relationship between the base on the left-hand side of the arrows and its conjugate acid on the right-hand side. You can tell when they're paired up like this, this is a conjugate base acid pair, because they differ in one proton. Well, it could be one or more protons. So here, the difference between the base on the left-hand side and the its conjugate acid on the right-hand side is the conjugate acid has one more H+, making a hydronium. Over here, the relationship between the acid on the left and its conjugate base on the right is that the conjugate base is the same as this minus an H+. One more word about the hydronium ion. We'll use hydronium ion and H+ interchangeably. The thing is, H+ stands for just a proton, no electrons, and it's basically a really small sphere of concentrated positive charge. In an aqueous solution, that is not going to be stable. That's going to grab one or more water molecules. And you see, that's what happens. If it grabs one water molecule, it becomes hydronium. So hydronium ion, it's more correct way. It describes the situation more accurately, but it's sometimes more awkward. So we'll flip back and forth between writing these. Just remember they're the same thing, as far as we're concerned. Next, Ka. Well, we had the equilibrium constant, we had K and Kp. Now, when we're talking about acids and bases, we have Ka. A stands for acid. This equation right here is our generic acid-base reaction. So there is no atom, with A, symbol A, right? A stands for basically the conjugate base of this acid. HA is a generic acid. When you put a generic acid any acid into water, the acid donates a proton to the water molecule, making the hydronium ion, leaving behind the conjugate base of the acid. Remembering that in a heterogeneous equilibria, which this is because of the liquid water, that liquids and solids do not appear in the equilibrium constant. If we write the equilibrium constant down for this equilibrium here, we get hydronium ion times the concentration of hydronium ion times the concentration of the conjugate base on top, concentration of the acid on the bottom, or H plus A minus over HA on the bottom. We're going to use this. You can look up the Ka for almost any acid. And we're going to use this actually quite a bit. All the stuff we did with the Ks and the Kps, plus a few more things. So, yeah, little example here. What is the conjugate base of acetic acid in an aqueous solution of acetic acid? So pause this, see if you can write it down, figure it out, and then come back and let's look at the answer. So acetic acid's formula is CH3CO2H. There's a few ways that we commonly write acetic acid. It could be CH3COOH, sometimes HCH3CO2. That's acetic acid. And this is an acid, so it donates a proton to water, making the hydronium ion and the acetate ion. The acetate ion differs from acetic acid by the loss of one proton, making it the conjugate base of acetic acid.